got to put that promotion on it. Then Jay, I'll get in there after. Woo, that's heat. That's a smoke.
That's missing smoke. The Ring magazine belt.
It'll come. Hey, Jay, you got it?
Yeah.
Let me show him in the middle, boys.
A lot of hardware.
Right here. Okay. Tom, TGB, please.
Yes.
Mr. TGB, our partner.
Our partner. Our co-defendant.
All right.
One more thank you. One more all right, guys, I got to clear the stage. The guys have another set of interviews to go.
Hey, Jay.
Thank you, Manny. Always good. Tada. Tada, Oba. Tada.
Who are we following?
We're good. We're good. One kick with the belt. Just one.
The belt on the line still, Tom?
Yeah, belt's on the line, baby.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Thank you.
Earl, good to see you. You look ready to fight tonight. You look slim.
Yeah, man. Getting there, man. Getting there.
You're ready. 6 more weeks.
Is there a difference in the hunger?
I think it's always a hunger, but I think that when you feel like something could have been taken from you, then you eat a little different. You feel close to it. So the hunger and desire are a little different. I think that could be a lot. And this is me just speculating on how it feels, but I'm just assuming the taste of it and the food tastes different.
Mm-hmm. So when he didn't want to say a lot about giving away the game plan. I'm not asking you for the game plan, but how do you go into a fight with Manny Pacquiao, this guy with this historical, prestigious resume? How do you go into this game plan to fight him?
He's just like everybody else. I mean, I think that you can't do him as this thing. And I think that at the same time, I think that you have to be able to. He's like an everyday individual. Like you can't look at him as some kind of god, some kind of whatever. Even though he is like considered a boxing god, a royalty. But you can't catch yourself watching Manny Pacquiao box you. That's what happened with a lot of guys. They watch Manny Pacquiao beat them, opposed to getting engaged and being involved in the fight.
So you got to get engaged. Is that the, do we pull that out of you right now? Being engaged and getting engaged?
I just said you can't watch him. You can't watch him beat you up.
Both you guys, man, super calm, super cool, real cool demeanor. You and Errol Spence are talking about. We're trying to get some game plan ideas here. And that's the only thing I got right now is getting engaged right now.
Well, engagement is great. You know what I mean? It's a fight. So, you know, some people like this. The costs that people may come out. You may have to, you have to be able to, something has to happen, right? People are going to start popping on the television. You know? There's going to be a little bit of engagement going on.
Do you get excited for this fight?
I stay on the ground. My feet on the ground. What I mean by that is that I'm not, it's like, I'm really so engaged. I really smell excitement. I took a job. I take that very seriously. And I'm not going to go okay until the fight is over.
Derek, I got to ask you this really quick. A lot of people don't give Errol Spence the credit he deserves. He's a phenomenal fighter, one of the best pound-for-pound. Manny Pacquiao, listening to him today, knows who he's fighting. He gave Errol the biggest compliment. He said he's better than Floyd. That's a huge compliment.
Right, definitely. You know what's funny about compliments and acknowledging is that people didn't like Jesus until he died and they told all the stories about him. So I think that you cannot worry about that. You just have to keep being the best and doing your best, and eventually, and if not, if they don't ever acknowledge it, it's okay too. You keep living your life and you know who you were, and the people will remember you.
He got the reaction out of him when the host asked Errol Spence about Mayweather calling him and giving him advice on how to beat Manny Pacquiao. Mayweather beat Pacquiao. That was his reaction. He was maybe a little bothered by it or whatever. What do you make of that?
I think it was funny that he. It really kind of was a joke to me. Like I think Pacquiao being funny, kind of saying, like, "Hey man."
He got a reaction out of those rare.
You don't need to listen to him, which is. I think it's funny. I think that. But he did come back and say, why would you listen to him basically because you're better than him?
Mm-hmm.
At this point.
And Floyd actually giving you guys advice, that would obviously be a plus in a positive way, you know?
Yeah, I don't listen to anybody's advice. I don't.
I'm gonna go get a little
cocky. No, I think he said he's gonna call Errol and tell Errol. Mm-hmm. I don't believe in that.
In terms of him talking to Errol, that'll be good for you. That'll be good for him.
I think it'll be good for him. Mm-hmm. Not for Errol, man. For Floyd, if he want to do it, it's up to him. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, I don't listen to people's advice. I think that because the thing about boxing and individual, people come in the gym and say, look at my son. I don't know what your son can do. So I'm saying, I don't know what he can do, how he throws the punches. So I know my place. I said, not give advice because I don't know who this kid is. Just watching him in 2 or 3 seconds, I can't tell him about the future of his life or predict that aspect of it. So I stay in my place.
Derek, are people blowing you up for tickets?
Hey man, yeah, man, come on.
So what's the number of people who want tickets?
I don't even know, man. I don't even count it. There's nothing I can do about it.
You don't have the tickets? No. They have to watch on pay-per-view?
Hey man, listen, I'm not buying tickets either. So it's like, people want tickets, man. They're not giving me tickets like that. Now I have to buy those tickets. I go to Vegas to make money, not to lose it.
When they faced off today, what went through your mind?
I'm nothing, man. It's just part of it. I think that this is like part of the dress rehearsal of the show that we've been involved in for 10 years as a pro fighter. So going to all those big fights, Floyd fights, Manny fights.
Canelo fights.
I mean, this is the fight that, those are all dress rehearsals and practices for this day, this time, this fight. And from this point on. So I think that it's just part of the game, man. It's like, you look at it and you say, that's what this was about. That's what those dates were about.
Derek, last thing regarding Canelo, since he was mentioned, he said he'd be open to a defense junior fight as low as 164. I know you guys got to worry about Manny first, but that's still a big fight, win or lose, Canelo. You know, would you guys be open to such a high jump, and how would you approach it?
The highest jump is to speak about Canelo and not focus on Manny. So, I mean, I do that. For me, take one step at a time. This is the last step, and we got to focus on that.
Smart. Thank you, Derek. Appreciate you.
Thank you, Derek. Thank you, Derek. Look like a different person in a suit, Derek.
Man, this is who I really am, man. You know what I mean? So, this is how when I was a kid, I wanted to be a fashion designer.
Yeah. I mean, so, it's your suit?
No, this is not.
Oh, I thought you. Yeah.
But, there was a time in high school I used to make my own clothes and do all this stuff. But, yeah, man.
That's cool. Well, press conference over. Now it's back to work. You're flying back today?
Flying back tonight, yeah.
Wow. Straight to the gym Monday.
Straight to the gym now after this.
Really?
We're going to the gym after this.
Yeah, that's incredible. But Earl looks in phenomenal shape. Looking at him, I told him he's ready to fight tonight.
Right, he's in shape, man. But you know, it's like the only way you continue to be who you are, you have to continue to do what you do.
And it was, I thought, a very successful press conference. Everybody paid attention. Right. Good personalities, good energy. Nobody needs to talk trash. It was just clean boxing. Message to Manny and his team, coach?
Hey, man, we're looking for a great fight, man. I know that they're going to come with him being 100% correct and 100% ready. That's what I look for. I know this is real. I mean, this is a big deal. And, you know, he's going to be the best.
One question. 1 week from yesterday, Jermell Charlo.
Yeah.
He's going to make history. He's going to have all the belts 154. What is that going to mean to you, coach?
Hey, man, I think this is just going to mean that I've done my job one more time. I mean, I think that, you know, with all the work, all the hard work, all the effort, all the travel, that I was able to do my job and be to him what he needed me to be for him.
All right, Derek, where do people follow you?
Derek B.J. and Warren.
Isn't it amazing? I know you're very familiar with the Hollywood work and how production works. Right. They cleared out this room in 20 seconds. We just, I've been, how quick was that? Yep.
Listen,
everything's gone. Well, have a good trip back, and we'll talk soon. Thanks so much for always for all the interviews. We appreciate it. And everyone tune in, pay-per-view on Fox. On August 21st, Elie Seckbach reporting.